is we're going to be taking the aprons out of this thing and replacing them with some stuff from National Parts Depot.
This week on Auto Resto Mod, Jeff and Cam continue to slog through the F100 sheet metal. Be sure to like and subscribe for more great videos on classic car mods and restorations.
National Parts Depot offers quality restoration parts for Mustang, Cougar, Camaro, Firebird, Chevelle, GTO, Chevy and Ford trucks, Bronco and Thunderbirds. For quality parts in stock and delivered fast from our four warehouses nationwide, nobody beats NPD's speed and service. For your free catalog, go online or call toll free. NPD, make your dream happen.
You've been a busy boy.
Yes, I have. You removed the wiring so that we can get this piece up. You know, when we bought this truck, we knew it wasn't perfect.
Yeah.
We bought it because it was like, there's a lot of projects that we could do.
So much room for activities.
Right. There's so much room for activities. I mean, like, we want to put AC in it. Mm-hmm. Well, we're trying to think. We're talking about talking to Vintage Air. Mm-hmm. But the bigger fish to fry this week is we're going to be taking the aprons out of this thing and replacing them with some stuff from National Parts Depot. We're not putting them back yet because we still got to do the cab mount.
Yep.
But we're going to be doing that. And then, you know, I don't know if we're going to do both of them.
Yeah, the other side's not really that bad.
It's not. The only bad problem is going to be is when we got the brand new one in on this side.
Then it goes into, while I'm here.
You got to love the while I'm here.
Let me just do this.
Then while the other I'm one, here. Yeah. Yeah. We've while I'm here at ourselves in that Camaro and the
like
67.
We'll pull the inner fender off. Might as well reseal the exhaust manifold that's leaking.
Because we're already going to do that anyway. That's something we're talking about doing actively. Because we got a seal problem on the manifold.
Might as well do the other one so it doesn't leak 5 miles.
Might as well replace the front bumper because we're going to be taking all that crap off anyway.
Might as well put new light bulbs in it.
It's out of hand! It's out of hand!
It's normal around here. What are you talking about? All right, first up is I'm going to take the bolts out of the front of the inner fender. There are four that go into the radiator core support, three that go down into the radiator core support from the top. I'm going to take the four out in front first. There's this half inch head bolts. And I'm going to use an impact because I'm lazy. It makes everything so much easier. And it scares small children. All right, next up is three on the top. Now, I highly recommend using some penetrating oil because that was with penetrating oil when it came out that hard. And that is really hot. So loud. All right, next up is the bolts in the back. All right, first thing on the back is, I don't know what it's exactly called, but I'm gonna call it a vibration dampener because that's what it looks like to me. There's three half inch bolts on it. Now we are going to replace that because, as you can see, it's kind of crusty. All right, next up is the 3/9/16 bolts on the back. These have nuts on the back side, and I've already sprayed these down with some penetrating oil as well. Now, next up, I'm going to take the bracket itself off the firewall. All right, now that I have an extension, take these completely out. The entire inner fender well should be loose. All right, upon further inspection off camera, we had to remove the back three bolts for the bracket that goes to the firewall because we simply didn't have enough room in the adjustment slots to slide it in far enough, which is when we found this bolt, which is severely corroded due to the factory installed shield on the bottom of the inner fender, which actually holds a bunch of water up and debris, dirt, everything. So it's a really bad rust spot. But with that out of there, I'm able to reach in and work this inner bracket deeper in to the inner fender well just by wiggling it and breaking all the rust up free. Need Jeff here to help me. Because this lip right in here, the inner fender well can't roll past it, but I can't pick it up either because of our spring perch, it'll hit. So I'm having Jeff pull the radiator core support forward so I can slide the inner fender well forward and pass that lip. Go ahead.
Oh,
roll the front out. And bada boom, it's done.
Viola.
Yay.
Oh, that's worse than it looked before. And while we're there.
All right, so while everybody's taking a break, eating a little pizza for lunch, I came out here and started mucking about with things. We got the apron off, and what I did while we were on break is I fixed the manifold gasket problem that we had on this side. I pulled the valve cover off and found out why we have a massive leak. That's because the intake manifold and the cylinder heads on our big block here are not mating up. So we're going to have to do something about that. And then I looked at this. No words. I don't even know why this happened. But it did. So this is something I'm actually going to focus on a future episode, because we did get a deal going with the guys at Vintage Air. They have just now released a brand new AC system for the 67 to 72 Ford pickup trucks. We're getting one from them to put in this truck to show you guys how cool and easy the system is to install. And while we're at this point, you're not going to get much easier. So, done with that. Going to move on to the bumper. That's going to be our last thing for this week. But I just want to tell you where we were at and some of the things that have been going on, because somebody's going to tell us, oh, look, they've been doing things and they didn't talk about it. We talked about it. Getting some tools, taking bumpers off. I'm going to be pulling the bumper off this thing because, quite frankly, the bumper is trashed. And we've also secured ourselves a used grill. I'm not going to wait for the new one to come out, and I've messed the one that we got up. So basically, there's just four bolts to get this out of here. But they can often be a pain because they're carriage bolts, and they're crunchy. They're underneath here. They've seen all kind of dirt and debris. But you have two per side. I'm going to go ahead and get these on out of here. It's going to take the bumper off to be replaced. Hopefully, the frame rails on this truck aren't damaged, because if the frame rails are damaged, it can cause you a real problem with your bumper on a Ford pickup truck, because there are no washers and there's not a whole lot of movement room on these bumpers. So we'll know pretty quick when we put the new bumper up on this thing if we've got a problem with that or not. So I'm going to go ahead and get all these bolts off, and we'll pull the bumper out of here in just a minute. Everything's been hit with PB Blast just to make sure that it comes off easily. Penetrating oil is your best friend on an old truck like this. All right, I'm going to get the bumper off of here, and then we'll go in and work on one last thing I want to get done this week before we move on. As in all things, one of them is stuck. A lot of times these carriage bolts will spin whenever you're working them. Since we're replacing the bumper, I'm not going to worry about what I do to the front of it. I'm going to try this with my Sawzall to see if I can get it to cut out. A little bit of PB Blast on this to help cool that off a little bit while I'm cutting it. Keep from wrecking too much of that blade. Yay! I'm gonna let that sit for a few minutes because I imagine it's pretty hot. So, take the bumper off in just a little bit because I'm not touching that. I can't get out. Too many things in the way! All right, so we got that one bolt cut off. Luckily, there's not like six across the front of this bumper. I'm gonna take the bumper now and pick it up and try not to hit the valance. Unfortunately, it looks like they didn't hit it with much paint either. Hopefully that'll clean up a little bit. And we'll have to do just a little bit of work on it to make it right. I'm gonna get this out of the way, and Cam's gonna talk to you a little bit about removing this panel right here so that we can get the condenser out for the next portion of what we're gonna be doing, which is putting vintage air in the truck. Just more and more things just going away. Bye.
All right, so now that Jeff's gotten the bumper off, I'm going to take the upper trim panel off. There are 10 bolts that need to be removed for this. Two over here, one right here. These two underneath this panel, one right here, and the two that we have already removed when we removed the inner fender. So I'm going to go ahead and get these ones off. I've already applied liberal amounts of good old penetrating oil. Slide that away. And now we have all the access we need to remove the condenser for the vintage air AC system.
So, I don't even want to go here, man. I know what you're going to do. One of the camera guys said we look like the two old men on the Muppets.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, we kind of do.
So, that's the worst show I've ever seen. So, okay, so now we've got, because we're doing AC.
While we're here.
Not going to pull the radiator. Yeah. Not doing a cam. We know nothing about that engine other than it still runs.
Yeah, and it runs really well.
And it runs well. There is a possibility that that is a 428.
Yes, a pretty good possibility.
Yeah, because it's got it's a Thunderbird V8. We figured that out because of some of the day coding and stuff. Ish. It could be Galaxy, could be Thunderbird. But we know that it's not a GT. I said that at one point, and I misspoke. What I meant to say was it is a 394 barrel.
Mm-hmm.
Because everything's common on that engine. But it could be a 428.
Yes. The block coating and the head coating is possible 428.
Possible 428. So we could have something like that going on. I'm sure somebody will write in and tell us that we, you know.
We're stupid.
Stupid.
Yeah.
But we knew that already anyway, so it's not like it's not news.
Welcome to the internet, folks.
So now we're doing air conditioning.
In a truck that doesn't seal.
I'm already talking to Scott about that. We're going to do the seals when we AC while we're here. But in order to do the seals, I got to repair the rust in the kick panels.
Yeah, and while we do
that, it'll whistle like...
We might as well fix the rust in the firewall. And then we can also get
That's just hideous.
Yeah, and we can also get the ABS firewall pad.
We got to do the ABS firewall pad because we're already there.
Yeah.
Because we're there.
I like how you're adding have to and gotta. It's no longer an option.
You're going to have me talked into a cam before it's all over with.
Yes.
We'll be pulling the heads off, doing an in-frame rebuild on it.
Got to figure out if it's 428.
I don't even care.
Explain the fuel economy.
390 explains the fuel economy.
Yeah.
That's what we got going on. Mm-hmm. We're going to be moving. There's going to be a lot going on. We're going to be on this thing for a little while.
Yeah.
Not a long while, but a little while. The next few episodes is going to be that because, I mean, this is a brand new product. And I'm willing to go do that.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody like Vintage Air is willing to come in and help us with something like this. I am definitely more than happy to spend a little bit of extra time on it. Cool new product. Really like the AC in the wagon.
That's cool.
And they were kind enough to do with us what we needed to do at that point. So I'm real happy with that. Well, folks, that's our show for this week. Be sure to come back and watch next time on
Auto Restomod.
Have a great week.
Muppets.
We will be the grouchy old man by the time this thing's done.